Underground markets, also referred to as the black market, is the area of the economy where transactions are performed without taxation or government regulation. Underground market activities include the sale of illegal drugs, prostitution, human trafficking, weapon sales, and copyright media such as CDs and DVDs. According to the National Center for Policy Analysis, the federal government is losing $195 billion per year in revenue due to the failure of people to report income and pay taxes on it. Figures over the last decade show a huge increase in black market revenue from illegal criminal activities such as drug dealing, as well as unreported income due to avoid taxation. The underground economy also includes transactions that governments may allow to be free of taxation by simply choosing to refrain from enforcement of tax laws in certain markets. The term underground economy is not usually used specifically to refer to the sale of stolen goods, which is referred to as the black market. Underground economy transactions are typically cash transactions to avoid traceability by governments. Measurement of the size of the underground economy is subject to a large margin of error. Economists seeking to measure the size have often looked at the volume of cash in circulation, although a large part of the underground economy takes place via bank accounts located in tax havens, making this method of measurement inaccurate.
Beginning in the 19th and 20th centuries, many countries began to ban the possession or use of various recreational drugs, such as the United States' famous war on drugs. Many people nonetheless continue to use illegal drugs, and a black market exists to supply them. Despite ongoing law enforcement efforts to intercept illegal drug supplies, demand remains high, providing a large profit motive for organized criminal groups to ensure that groups are available. The United Nations has reported that the retail market value of illegal drugs is worth about $321.6 billion yearly. While law enforcement efforts do capture a small percentage of the distributors of illegal drugs, the high and very inflexible demand for such drugs ensures that the black market prices will simply rise in response to the decrease in supply, in turn encouraging new distributors to enter the market in a perpetual cycle. Many drug legalization activists draw parallels between the United States' experience with alcohol prohibition and the current bans on various psychoactive drugs. In certain countries, firearms remain illegal to own and or use by civilians or even police officers, so many people who want one of these items must buy them illegally through black market channels. In some countries, firearms are legal, although specific types of weapons, such as automatic weapons or weapons with a sound suppressor, are still illegal. In order to obtain these types of weapons, people will go into the black market. The black market firearms trade remains high due to the high demand by organized crime and gang culture, as well as from firearms collectors. As you can see, the underground economy is quite a broad topic, and there have been many different types of them throughout history. It is an area of the economy that is difficult to study and understand because of its illegal nature, but it is important not to define the underground market by the illegal activities that often go on within it. Many transactions are done without either party paying taxes, such as on Craigslist, eBay, or simply when selling something to a friend or family member, or at a yard sale. As we move into the future, it'll be interesting to see how products such as illegally produced CDs and DVDs fit into the underground market and what regulations are put in place to counter copyright violations.